Hello and welcome to this quick look at the turbidity sensor. The turbidity sensor is used to look at the amount of material that's present in a sample of water. And this would typically be used when you're doing a water quality study or if you were looking at the growth rate of something in the water sample. So to start off, we're going to go ahead and connect our turbidity sensor to our interface using the cable that comes with the turbidity sensor. Once it's connected and normed up a little bit, we're going to go ahead and calibrate it. And it has a built-in calibration, so you're going to do it on the sensor, not in the software. So to do so, we're going to go ahead and put in a sample of deionized water. And we also want to make sure this is all completely cleaned off and there's no fingerprints on the vial. We're going to put that in, and we're going to press the button. And what it's going to do is it's going to start the calibration process. A little light comes on the button. And then once that light starts blinking, what you're going to do is you're going to take that sample out, and you're going to replace it with the 100 NTU sample that comes with the turbidity sensor. So I'm going to go ahead and stir that up just a little bit. I'm just going to gently rock it back and forth. I don't want to actually shake it. And I'm going to go ahead and put that into the turbidity sensor. And I'll press the button one more time. And it's going to take a few seconds more to get that second reading. The turbidity sensor is measuring scattered light, so it's sending a white light into the sample. And it's looking at the light that is scattered by the sample, the nephelometric unit, or the nephelometric system. And therefore the nephelometric unit is what we're measuring. This is a 100 nephelometric unit sample that comes with the device. So once it's done calibrating, we should see approximately 100 NTU on the screen, which we do. And when we're done, we can just go out and collect samples from our river or the samples that we happen to be using in the lab, place them in the turbidity sensor, and take measurements. We can do that both as individual samples from different locations, discrete samples, or as a continuous sampling if you want to look at the rate at which something is growing in the sample. We hope you really enjoy using this with your students, and don't forget to practice safe science. Thank you.